Hello, my dear students. Let's continue with lecture 4, part 2. Accessing the values of an array. The values of any of the elements in an array can be accessed just like the value of a regular variable of the same type. Syntax, name of array and index of element. For example, the following statement stores the value 75 in the third element of my array. So here we have index that is equal to 2, but we work with the third element because remember that we always start with 0. The first index is 0 in the array. And for example, the following copies the values of the third element of array to a variable called x. So we copy this from the value of the third element of the array. We assign this value to variable of x. It is important to be able to clearly distinguish between the two uses of brackets have related to array. They perform two different tasks. One is to specify the size of the array when they are declared. And the second one is to specify indexes for concrete array elements when they are exceeded. Do not confuse these two possible uses of square brackets with array. Example, here in this line, this is the declaration of a new array, my array. This is the name of array. It consists of 5 elements and int type of the array. And here we access to an element of the array, or we assign this value 75 to this element with index 2, but it's a third element. Some other valid operation with array. We may assign to element of the array any variable, like here we assign the value of this variable, or we may use variable like index here, not just number. But this variable must be of type int. And we may assign to some variable value of array and use here not just a number, but variable plus a number. So here we go expression. And we may use like index element of array. It's an integer number, of course. And here assign expression to it. Let's consider this example how we work with array. Here we declare this array 4 and do initialization of the initial value of this array. And here we find just a sum using this compound operator. Here starting our loop for initial value condition increase. And here we just take one by one each element and sum them. And in result will be sum. Okay, this number as a result. Let's speak about input of all elements of one-dimensional array. You may do this input using a loop for. So, for example, if we have this array, we need to write loop starting from 0 because the first index in array is 0, and then put the condition the increase, and our loop will do this operator that number of iterations that is equal to number of elements in this array. Output of elements of the array. We can display all elements of the array by looping through each element of the array. Example. Here we use function cout to display each element of the array on the screen. So we use loop 4 for this here. Initial value of loop 4, a condition, increase, and we do it that number of iterations that is equal to number of elements of the array. And please note here, I put blank between double quotes. It means we'll see on our screen number, then blank, then number, then blank, and so on. Let's consider task 1. Find the sum of all elements of the array. A, 5. This is the value of our array. And we'll find sum like this. Let's consider program. Here, we start from main. And here we declare array, do initialization, here goes value of our array, and here we do declaration of parameter of the loop, of our loop, then declaring variables sum, our result, and we assign initial value for sum. That is equal to 0. Then we start our loop. Initial value of I of our parameter of loop is equal to 0. And the first index of array is equal to 0. So we check condition and increase each iteration. And here we find our sum. Sum is equal previous sum plus value of the this first of all the first element of the array, because first value of I will be 0 here, and then it will be equal to 1. So first we take this a 0, then a 1, then a 2, and so on, and sum them, and then in this line we sum on the display on the screen text sum is equal to and value of our sum. But we may assign this value like this in the program. Not here, not during the initialization, but like this. Let's consider task 2. Find the product of all elements of the array. So we need to find this. Let's consider program, and here we did declaration of I of our variable product. We did declaration of array A. This is the value of array. Please note, they need to be positive, not positive, but not equal to 0. And here we did, we assign 1 like initial value for our product. And then here in loop, we find our product, the same loop, but here we multiply by each element, 1 by I, 1 by 1. In each iteration, we take next value. First of all, we work with A0 multiplied by previous product. So product will be equal 1 multiplied by this. And then in the second iteration, it will be our new product will be previous product. It was 5 multiplied by next element multiplied by 1. A1 is equal to 1. And A2 next iteration will be to 7 and so on. And when we finish our loop, we leave our loop and we print out product is equal, and here goes value of our product. Let's consider task 3. Find the number of all positive elements of the array 5, A5. Here, please note that we assign 0 like initial value to number. And then we starting to find number of all positive. And if we need to find number of positive, so here must be a condition. And we have this condition: if ai greater than 0, this is our condition. So this is our loop. Our loop and condition before this statement. So first of all, I is equal 0. We take I 0, so this element minus 2, and check the condition. I 0 minus 2 greater than 0? No. So we don't go here. We didn't count our number. So we go to the next iteration and check. We take the next I 1 and we work with 0, 0 greater than 0? No. We don't take it. And so on. We check each element. We check condition. And when we leave our loop, we just print out number is equal our value of number. And task 4. Find the greatest element or maximum of the array A5. Let's consider our program. Here, please note, after all declaration, array and variable, we assign as initial value for max the first element, value of the first element. It just to start to work with our array. So, first of all, in max will be the first element of our array. And to find maximum, we need to have condition here. So our condition will be, if ai will be greater than max, then we mark to max assign the value of this element. If not, we don't go here. So first of all, it will be in max minus 2, and we check. Oh, but first of all, we compare this minus 2 with our minus 2. So we are interested in the next iteration. So we take 0 and comparing 0 greater than max. Yes, greater, because in max we have minus 2. So we change the value in max. And now in max will be 0, and so on in each iteration. And this is the end of our lecture. Thank you very much. Goodbye.